Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. Today I want to show you how you can solve the black screen issue in OBS. All right, well, let's jump to it. Here I am on my desktop and you can see my webcam down there in the corner of OBS and I have a big black screen right here. So how do I resolve this? Well, so what we're gonna do today, it's a pretty simple process to fix this. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go down to Windows search here and then we're gonna type in graphic settings. It should pop up as the best match in the results. I'm gonna go ahead and click on that and that brings up the Windows graphic settings. And what we want to do is we want to come down here. We want to choose the graphics performance preference. And you have two different types of apps that you could choose, either a desktop app or a Microsoft Store app. OBS is a desktop app. So let's go ahead and click on desktop app. In older versions of Windows, it's referred to as classic app. So depending on your version of Windows, you might see different text appearing there. So once we select desktop apps, click on browse. And what we want to do now is we want to browse to where OBS is on the file system. So I'm just going to go back and I have OBS installed on my C drive. You're going to find OBS under program files. And then within your program files, you want to go to OBS-Studio. So let's click on OBS Studio. And within OBS Studio, you want to click on the folder called bin. And then 64-bit, and then I have my OBS 64 application right here. I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. Now, it's added OBS Studio to my graphics performance preference, and so what I could do now is I can click on options. And so we have a few different options here. You have three different options: let Windows decide, power saving, or high performance. Now, a little bit of, I wanna say a quick word on why OBS shows a black screen. So on my computer, I have two different graphics cards. One is the integrated graphics card, and one is my high performance NVIDIA GeForce graphics card. Now, typically what the computer will do is my Intel graphics card uses less power. And for things like my desktop, or let's say Word, Excel, PowerPoint, it'll use the power savings graphic card or the Intel graphic card to run those applications because it uses less power. If let's say I'm playing a game or I'm doing 3D visualizations, it'll use the high performance or the NVIDIA GeForce card, but it uses more power. So what my computer is trying to do is it's trying to minimize the amount of power that it uses. The trouble for OBS is you need to tell OBS, hey, if I'm recording my desktop, you need to look at this Intel graphics card. If I'm playing a game, hey, OBS, you need to look at my NVIDIA GeForce graphics card. So you need to tell OBS which graphics card to use essentially when you're recording. And so in this case, I have a black screen because I'm trying to record my desktop, in which case I want to use the Intel graphics card because that's what's used for things like the desktop. So think of it this way, anything that doesn't have the graphics changing much and it's pretty limited in terms of the power you need from the graphics card, go with the Intel or the integrated graphics card. For anything like games where you have lots of effects and lots of things moving, you want to choose high performance. So I'm going to go ahead, let's click on save. And now OBS is set to use my integrated or Intel graphics card. So I'm going to move this aside. What I need to do now is OBS is still showing a black screen. I need to close OBS. Now I'm going to reopen OBS. And what we should see now is OBS will detect the background. So here's OBS and it is now showing the background on my computer. It's showing the desktop and it's recording just like I expect it to. All right, well, that was a quick tutorial showing you how you can get rid of the black screen issue in OBS. It's just a matter of making sure that you choose the right graphics card that you want to record off of. If this video helped you get around the black screen, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, hit that subscribe button. That way you'll get a notification anytime new content like this comes out. And lastly, if you have any other questions, any other things you want me to cover in the future, leave a comment down below. I read them all and I'll add it to my list of videos to create. All right. Well, that's all I had. See you next time. Bye.